Hi lovely fire signs, welcome to Joy Energy Tarot. I'm Jenny. This is your guided intuitive reading for January the 23rd. If you like it, please push like and subscribe, and if it doesn't resonate, that's fine, watch another lovely reader. I've already done all the shuffling, so we've got the tarot reading here, and then we've got guided messages from our lovely Kyle Gray, Keepers of the Light, for Aries, Leo and Sagittarius. So let's get started. A message from our lovely Louise Hay. The moment I say positive affirmations, I step out of the victim role. I am no longer helpless. I acknowledge my own power. I am taking the next step for my healing. So that's really, really good. That's a very important message. So whenever you're feeling down or you feel like you need healing, use affirmations that resonate to you. Make up your own, because they really do change the way you look at things and the way you think. Then we go on to the week of the 23rd. If you've got a 23 or a 5 in your chart, you like change. You get bored really, really quickly. You're very good at communicating too. This goes on to the 29th, which is a powerful number, a 29-11. Sorry, it can reduce to 11. You guys are here to lead the way as far as giving good advice. People will come to you for information. You will be speaking very important words which are actually guided from above, so be careful how you say things. Right, let's get started. What is happening? Okay, so you start off the week where you're trying to decide, five of wands, which direction will I go on? For some of you, this card and other packs represents conflict going on around you, fighting, arguments. But I feel in this one, it's more that you've learnt from conflict, or you've learnt from what's been happening, and you're now plotting your next move. But because it's a wands, this can be to do with, where do I want to work? Where do I want to live? I'm making a change and I'm making a choice. It doesn't have to be negative. It can be quite positive. So fives are about change, freedom, communication. So you're working out what you want to do. And the clarifier is the Ace of Wands. So you will make your mind up, because here you've got a new beginning. You're learning something new. So you could be on the road to learning something new. You could be working somewhere different, or starting a new job, or a new garden, or a new house, or a new course, something like that. But the Ace of Wands is the beginning of something new. It's going to help you learn with your life as well. And it's going to help you grow, the Ace of Wands. Usually it's a new job, you know. Okay, and then you've got the Two of Swords. So you've been learning something new, or you could have been looking up your research too, and then you've got this Two of Swords. So some of you are still waiting for some sort of legal outcome. For others of you, you're trying to make your mind up about something, and you can't make your mind up. You've pulled the wool over your eyes. You don't want to know. So this is a card of, once you make your mind up, or once that decision comes through, it'll be a weight off your shoulders. And clarifying, it is the Judgment card. So you've done everything right. You've earned your angel wings. It's time to blow your own trumpet. This is a card now of leaving that past behind, clearing out the negative thoughts, clearing out the negative people, clearing out cupboards, giving things to charity, moving forward so that you can allow new things to come into your life. So because that was near the Ace of Wands, next to the Ace of Wands, I feel like you've got this new beginning, which is because you, or the new beginning is enabling you to walk into the future now and leave behind those things. You then go on to the Page of Pentacles. So this is information coming in. It's coming in a little bit slowly, but it's helping you grow. It's something that you've been waiting for, and some sort of good news. Then you have the Queen of Cups. It's going to make you feel, for some of you, it's information to do with a mother or a friend who's kind and caring and generous. For others of you, this is going to make you feel more in touch with your intuition, and you're going to be feeling a lot happier about this. And right next to that King of Pentacles, next to the Page of Pentacles is the King of Pentacles. So it's like, yes, thank you. All that work that I've been doing, I'm finally starting to feel successful. I'm starting to see the results. This is a money card too. It's money, safety, security, feeling grounded, feeling practical. So if that's not you, there's somebody around you like that that can help you, give you the info and give you the things that you've been wanting. Okay? This can be a farmer too, by the way. It's somebody like that that's worked very hard to get where they are at. Yeah, look, he's on top of the world. Made it. Yo-ho. And actually, underneath him, you've got the King of Swords. So some of you, there's the King of Swords and King of Pentacles right next to each other, clarifying each other. So this can either be you or people around you. But this can be a lawyer or a teacher. This is somebody who's very, very wise. They've learnt so much. They are really, really wise. They can now see completely clearly, keep their emotions out of a situation. This can be a Gemini. So this person, it can also be you, where all the things you've been learning, you're at the top of your field, you've learnt so much. And this is like being in tune with all of those, all that information and all of the knowledge that you have. Okay. So covering the whole reading, whatever's happening to you this coming week, it's going to enable you to leave behind old emotions. So all these emotions that were probably holding you back, you've now earned your angel wings, you're moving forward, you're leaving those things behind, and that's what this is about. It's being able to, instead of having those emotions holding you back, you're now being able to leave them in the past where they belong, and you are transforming. This has got the lovely butterflies, flowers, it's got swans and ladybird and dragonflies, which are all about hope, faith and transformation. So you are ready now, eights to me are karmic. What goes around comes around. I feel that you're ready now to, you've earned your angel wings, you've done everything right, you've done the karmic things. You're now transforming and your life is transforming. Fantastic. You're still worrying though, overthinking things. So this doesn't have to be negative. It just can be where you're waking up thinking about what you want to do, all your plans that you've got. It doesn't need to be worrying necessarily, okay? But I thought I'd ask for a clarifier. And the clarifier is you have been looking for something and searching for something, but they're saying you're looking in slightly wrong direction. Hang in there, keep looking, but look in a different direction for what you want. And then the world will be your oyster. Things will open up for you. You'll get the results. So this is really good. Like the Hangman, both of these are major arcana. This is about doing the hard work, putting in the work. You will get the results that you want. You're making sacrifices and you will get the results that you want, but look in a slightly different direction. And then you've got the world. So the world's going to open up for you. You're going to beginning a new chapter in your life, which then you've got the Four of Wands, gives you that stability at home and at work, or if you're retired, it's giving you that stability and happiness and contentness, and then you're going to be have that freedom because you'll feel stable. That's what this is about too. The King of Pentacles is about finally getting, after lots of hard work, feeling stable, connected to Mother Earth, having the money that you want, having everything balanced. It's actually, that's what I'm trying to get and spit out. You've got the balance back in your life and that will enable you to feel free again. Okay, so what a great week for you guys. Right, we've got the Keepers of the Light from our lovely Kyle Gray this week. Aries, what have you got? So Aries, what do you need to know this week? Ooh, Kelly Ma, facing fears. Okay. Look at that beautiful art. Major spiritual changes are unfolding. This is your chance to soar, Aries. This is a time when you're able to look fear in the eye and move away from it. Fear is just energy, and energy can be changed. This can be an intense experience because the human self is so conditioned that it may be used to operating with fear present. When the fear is gone, it may feel as though an emptiness is there, but this is a space for love and miracles to enter. You are being filled with the courage of spirit now so that you can move from this phase of your life to the next. Trust the process and call on Kelly Ma to help you. Release your fear and step into space that is strong, focused and courageous. Step into a space that's strong, focused and courageous, Aries. Woohoo! And from the the Magic of Nature spirit cards, we have Overseas Connection. A An overseas connection is coming in for you and it will be very fortuitous. Spread your wings and fly. Woohoo! So maybe some of you have to get over that fear of travelling again. You are in control of your own destiny. Okay, Aries, take control and do it. Have a wonderful, wonderful week. Okay, let's move on to Leo. What have you got? Sorry, just trying to read that. Leo. Okay, Leo, what have you got? Kathumi, Cloak of Wisdom. Right, I'm looking up the wrong spelling. Here we go. Leo, look at that lovely yellowy gold Leo colour. You already know the answer you seek. Trust what you know, Leo. Knowledge is learned. Wisdom is remembered. You are in a real cloak of wisdom now. Like Kathumi, you have been on a wandering path, trying to find answers through study and the insights of others. But now you are uncovering the truth of your own soul. Your soul is leading the way and you're being encouraged to follow. The fog is clearing. The light has come and it is shining on you. Your soul is saying, yes, it's your cheerleader. Follow it and trust the endless wisdom within you. Go, 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 Leo. Woohoo. And you've got abundance. All is destined to turn out beautifully and you have a magnificent and abundant future ahead of you. All your dreams will come true, so stop worrying, Leo. Lovely. And your angel message, you're being guided by unseen forces. Have faith, all is well. Wow, that's fantastic. Have a great week, Leo. And Sagittarius, what have you got? Gaia, or Papa Tuanuku, we say in New Zealand. Earth connection. Mother Earth. Sagittarius. Be mindful of the planet. Come back to Earth and stay grounded. You are blessed to receive this Great Mother card today because it shows that the Earth itself, through the image of Gaia, is protecting your path. You are a strong, focused, and loving individual. Stay grounded and don't allow your imagination, ego, or fears to run away with you. Ensure your choices are for the highest good. Gaia is also bringing her motherly love to you and encircling you in a cocoon of peace. If you have had troubles with a mother in your life or are feeling disconnected from or grieving your own mother, Gaia helps revitalize that connection and will bring healing where it is possible. If you are a mother and you're worrying about these duties, know that Gaia is thanking you for your hard work and commitment. The earth is blessed to have you, Sagittarius. Oh, isn't that lovely? And you've got independence. Do it alone. You need to act independently at this time without any input from others. This needs the purity of your soul essence. Okay, Sagittarius, you will know what that means and what that relates to. And your angel message, simplify your life and the answer you seek will appear. Okay, lovelies, I hope you have the most amazing week and thank you so much for watching. Blessings to you all. See you all again. Bye. Ka kiri anō. Bye.